In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a screen at the start of your game that will give the user some instructions. I'm going to allow the user to move to the start of the game or to exit the game using buttons. Also, you'll notice on screen that I have some images on my screen. All I've done here is dragged onto the sprites onto the room that I've created. Just to allow me to have some graphics on the welcome screen. You have to drag the sprites on and not the objects. Objects won't work properly. You have to use sprites because they're non-interactable, okay? It will ask you to create an assets layer when you do this, so make sure that you you do that and because it won't let you drag them onto the instance layer. But when you are coding, make sure that you always, when you're using objects, make sure they go into the instance layer, not the assets layer. So all I've done is I've created a new room, I've dragged on some sprites, and I've created just a simple image on the screen. The Monster Maze heading, I've used an online tool that allows me to create a 3D text heading. And what I've done with that, when I've created the sprite, I've gone into the sprite itself, I can find it. It is the game title. There it is there. And you can see that I've created a animation which does that. Okay, so it just moves the title up and down slightly just to give it a bit of an effect. Okay, you can do that when you create the sprites itself. Okay, so let's go back to the room. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do in this room, oh, I've also created some buttons by the way as well. So I've created three sprites, okay. One for exit game, one for restart game, and one for start game. So obviously the start and the exit game are going to be on the welcome screen. The restart button is going to be on the lose screen and the win screen because you might want to have another go. So I'll show you how to code those later. So I'm going to close those down just for a second. Okay, so next thing that I want to do then is to open up my GUI controller, because I need to add some text to my start screen. So I'm going to go on to my start screen. So I want to add some text sort of around this sort of area. Now what I've done, I've already created my text for my game in Notepad. This is going to be easier for me to copy and paste into the text tool that's going to create the text onto the screen. So this is going to be my caption, okay? And then this is then going to be my body text. And I can copy and paste this straight into the coding window. Don't forget the backslash and the N, those are new lines. So they force new lines in the text. You'll see that in a minute when I create the text. Okay, let's get make a start then. So on my object, I'm gonna go onto my object controller GUI and I want a draw event. Okay, so this is where we worked in the last video on the win screen. I'm going to do something similar now on my start screen. So I'm just going to click and I'm going to drag here. You can see that it's put a new case in there for me. And I'm just going to type in RM underscore start, which is my start room. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this one, the draw color and the draw value. I'm going to copy these two by holding down shift and highlighting these two blocks. I'm going to copy it, I'm going to come down to the case and I'm going to paste it in. Now I want to use that text, so I'm going to but my remember I got a black background, so I'm going to change the color of my font and I'll change it to a bright color so you can see that quite clearly. Okay, and then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use my Notepad file and I'm going to copy and paste my caption across into the draw value. So I'm going to copy that. I'm going to make sure I keep the speech marks. Don't forget that you need the speech marks. And I'm going to paste that in. Okay, and then I'm going to do the same thing on the rest of the text, all the way down to the bottom. I'm going to copy that and I'm going to paste that in. like that. Okay, let's have a little look at what that looks like so far. So press the play button, and surprisingly, it's starting on my level one. Well, I can't see the game start screen. And to fix that, if you look at the rooms, you'll see I've got a little house on level one. That means that's the home screen, that's the start. So I need to make sure that I'm setting the start screen as my home screen. So to do that, I just click on the little house, I click on my start screen, and I move it to the top. So I click this button here, center top, and that then becomes my first room. Okay. There's something else that we have to do though, because we've set this now as our first room. At the moment, we've dragged in our persistent GUI object onto level one. So if I show you what I mean, if I close this down and I press play, it shows me the start room, but the text doesn't show. Now the reason for that is because if we go on to level one, okay, you can see that up here, I've dragged in my my GUI controller. Well, I want to delete it from there because I don't want it in there. I want it on my start screen. So I'm just going to drag in my GUI controller object onto my start screen. You'll notice it's an X there. Okay, that's an error because what I'm trying to do is to drag an object onto the assets layer. So if you get that, make sure that you cancel because you don't want to create a new instance layer. Click on the instance layer and then drag in the controller object like so. Okay, let's start this then. Let's run the game. And you can see now that my text is there, but it's in the wrong place. So it's down to you to start messing about with those settings to see where you want it put. So I'm going to close that down. I'm going to open up the GUI controller. I've already done some work on this, so I know that I want mine set to 400 on the X, and I want it set to 300 on the Y. 300 on the Y. Now, when I run that, there's still a problem, which we're going to sort out now. When I run that now, you can see that it's now in a more sort of sensible place, but I've got this going on, okay? I've got this cut off text. So what we need to do is to put another line break in between the, I would probably go there, so the destroy starts on the next line. So let's close that down and let's scroll through our text. So we're looking for where it says destroy. Destroy the boss. Okay, so what I want to do is get rid of that space. I'm going to press the backspace, backslash key and N. So let's run that now and see what difference that makes. So now you can see that I haven't got the cutoff text now. Okay, so that's lovely. That's working fine so far. Although I think I might want a different font. So I've already created a different font. So you remember we created the game font, which was this one. I've created a start font as well, which is this one. So it looks slightly different. So what I want you to do, or what I'm going to do, is I'm going to tell my GUI controller that it's going to start a different font. So what I want is the set font, which is there. I'm going to drag it to the top there, drag it back up. There we go. And I'm going to tell it what font I want to use. I want to use the start font. And now if I run the game again, you should see that I've now got a different font, but I've got some issues now that this is now coming off screen again. So let's move this across just a little bit on the X. So let's move the X to 350. Try that. Still not. Okay, so I think what I'm gonna have to do is to go onto my game font, sorry, my start font, and reduce the size of that font. So let's bring it down to 14. Okay, let's try that. Let's run the game. There we go, that's better. Okay, so we've got a different font, and that's now laid out on the screen nicely. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is to create, or at least to drag on the buttons that I'm going to need to use for this particular room. So I'm going to go onto my my start room, and I'm going to drag on my objects for my start button. So let's put the start button there, and let's drag on the exit button, and we're going to drag that there. And let's have a look how that looks. Okay, that's not so bad. So I'm happy with those. So now is a case of coding these buttons. So let's go onto the exit button. Okay, and what I want to do onto my exit button, I want to add an event. And what I want to do is to mouse left pressed. Okay, so when you click the mouse, the left mouse button. When I click the left mouse button on that button, I wanted to exit the game. So if I type in exit, and there's exit game. So I'm gonna drag that and just drop that on. Okay, that's that done. So let's close that one down. Let's try the start button. Again, we're gonna add an event. We're gonna do mouse left pressed again. And this time, when I click the left mouse button, I want to go to a specific room, and we want to go to level one, RM underscore level one. So let's check those out and see if those work okay. So let's run the game. So let's start with the exit button. You can see that I've clicked that and it's now exited the game. Let's run the game again. And let's click the start game button. And you can see that's now gone straight to level one. Brilliant. So we've got a working menu system. So the only thing we need to do now is to add the restart button, which we're going to code now, onto the win and the lose screens. So I'm going to add another event. I'm going to set up a mouse left pressed again, and this time I'm going to restart the game. Okay, so we're going to look for restart. Restart room, restart game. So we're going to restart the game. So let's see if that works. Before we do that though, let's go onto the lose screen and drag on the restart button. What's the wrong? Try that again. Okay, that's, I think I've put the wrong sprite on there. So let's just get rid of that. And let's go back onto this button. And we're going to, yes, I put the wrong sprite on. So let's change the sprite on that to the restart. Okay. Okay. Let's go back onto the lose screen. Try to drag that back on again. There we go, that's better. Where should we put the button? Let's put the button there on the on that window. And let's go on to the win screen, and let's put the restart button. Let's put the restart button on the graphic. Okay, so let's give that a go. So let's test this game then to make sure that all of the buttons work, and it works as it should. So let's run the game. So the first thing we're going to test then, does the exit game button work? Yes, it does. Okay. Let's try the start game button. Does that work? Start game should take us to level one, and it does. So let's firstly try and lose our lives. One, two, three, and that takes us to the lose screen. Okay, you'll notice we didn't get any points. So let's restart the game again. Let's get some points just to show that the points is working. So we've got 100 points. One, two, three. Okay, so the score's 100 points on the screen. You can see it there. If I restart the game, start the game again, my points will be set to zero, so that's fine. So let's try moving to the last level. Okay, and let's get rid of the boss. Okay, and we come across now to our apple, and there we win the game. Let's restart the game. Start the game. So that's all working. So I'm happy with that. So we've now got a fully working game that has a menu screen and allows us to restart when we either lose our lives or we complete the game. So the only thing left to do now is to add sound effects and music to the game, which I'll show you how to do in the next video.